subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we will try to solve some examples on SOP and POS. SOP means it is sum of products and product of sums. In our previous classes, we have covered clearly what is how a Boolean expression can be represented by using sum of products, and also how a Boolean expression can be represented by using product of sums. Now, based upon that knowledge, hoping that you have already watched that video, we are going to solve these examples. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better insights of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now, coming to this example, so as we have seen, if you are given with a Boolean expression, how it can be represented in SOP, sum of products, or product of sums is one of the methods is we have already seen for this example. So in the previous videos, we have discussed about this example. So we are going to draw the truth table of the four variable combinations. So all the combinations that are possible with four variables, and we are going to apply each and every input on this expression. If it is going to get a zero, so that will be noted. So for example, if you take 0, 0, 0, 0, so A is 0, B is 0, C is 0. So it is going to produce an output of 0. Okay. So the output that is produced by just giving the inputs directly onto that based upon the truth table. So we have seen the truth table also, and identifying the ones and writing the expressions, writing the minterms which has been obtained their output as 1 is going to give the SOP, and the max terms which have obtained an output of 0 is going to be represented. So all those max terms, product of all those max terms is going to be represented as product of sums. That is one way. So here we will try to produce the SOP. So for this it is going to be SOP, so sum of the product value for this example, and also POS for this, because here it is product of sums and this is sum of products and that is sum of products. So we will, as we have already seen the sum of product values for this, we will try to check whether that is going to be same as that of, so the output that we are going to get for this is going to be the same as that of the example that we have seen in our previous videos. How to do that? We have to expand this. How to expand this is x bar y plus xyz is given. How to expand this is we have to take the variables that are missing. For that we have to take x plus x bar. So now we have to expand this. So general algebraic expansion this is. So why we have taken this is, if you have x bar y dot 1, so is it going to make any difference? 1 means 1 dot anything is going to be x bar y. So a dot 1 is equal to a. Okay, so in the place of 1, I have taken z plus z bar, because z plus z bar, if the value of z is equal to 0, z bar is equal to 1, so it is going to be 1. So that is the reason why I have taken z plus z bar for the missing variable. So we have missed, so here we are having 3 variables, we have missed z. So in order to fulfill that, we have, in order to expand that, we are using this z in this way. Okay, now just expand it. So it is going to be x bar y z plus x bar y z bar, and this is going to be remain as it is, because we have all the variables in a single minterm. So this is what we call it as a minterm with all the variables. Okay, so the final expression is going to be this one. And what is the other representation of this expression, how it can be represented? It is 0, 1, 1, 3, comma, 0, 1, 0, 2, comma, this is going to be 7. Okay, now coming here, it is product of sums. How to represent it? How to represent it is x plus y plus we are missing Z. So how the Z has to be written? It is Z bar. Okay, why we have taken this? Because Z bar is going to be a zero. It is product. So if the value of Z is equal to zero, Z bar is going to be 1. So 0.1 is going to be a 0. So adding a 0 to sum, it does not make any difference. So adding a 0 to 1 is going to be x plus y. So that is the reason why we have taken this. And for this also, what we are missing is x bar. X is missing. So in the place of x, we are going to take x bar plus y plus z. Okay, so now we have to expand this. So how to expand this? This is distributive law. So this operator has to be distributed over this. So how that is done? So clearly all the properties were clearly explained. So please watch those videos. It is x plus y plus z and x plus y plus z bar. Similarly, if you take this is distributive law. This operator is expanded over dot. So it is going to be x plus y plus z and x bar plus y plus z. So we have x plus y plus z and x plus y plus z repeated. So we are going to strike off that. So the final equation is going to be this one. So the expression is going to be this one. So what it is? It is 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0 means 0. And this one is 0, 0, 1, 1. And this is 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0 is 4. Okay. So this is the final answers. Now coming to this, so this is going to take a lot amount of space. The third example, we'll try to solve it. We'll erase this and we'll try to solve that. So given we have four variables and the expression is a plus bc. So the example has already been covered. So we have already covered that example. For example, if you take a plus bc, four variables are there. How it can be written is a into b plus b bar, c plus c bar, m plus m bar. Because we are missing all these variables, a dot 1 dot 1 dot 1, nothing is going to happen. It is going to remain as a, and this part is going to be taken as a plus a bar. BC is there and missing is M plus M bar. So we'll take it as bar. M plus M bar BC. Now expand this. So in order to expand this, it is going to be, so we'll go slowly. BC bar, B bar C bar. And if we expand this with A, multiply with A. So a b c bar a bar c a b bar c, and again we have to multiply this with m and m bar. So this has been evaluated to this. So now we are left with m plus m bar. Okay, again doing the multiplication, a b c m bar plus a b c bar m plus a b c bar m bar a b bar c m plus a b bar c m bar, and next one is a b bar c bar. b bar c bar. Okay, a b bar c bar m plus a b bar c bar m bar. Okay, so this part has been evaluated, and next we will go with this. It is a okay, so AM plus AM bar plus A bar M plus A bar M bar, and if we multiply this with BC, so this plus, we are going to add this two. So if you multiply this with BC, so it is going to be ABC ABC M, okay, it is ABC M bar A bar BC M A bar BC M, and this is A bar BC A bar BC MB. Now removing the common elements, this is common, and next so is it there ABC M bar ABC M bar, it is not there, okay. Next one is ABC bar M ABC bar M AB C bar M, it is also not there. A B C bar M bar A B A B C M bar is there, okay. A bar A bar B C M bar. So you try to expand this. So with this we can, so you, if you, you check this and you expand this, it is going to be, so the final answer is going to be 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So the final answer will be this one. So the min terms of 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 will be there in the output term. Okay. So this is how this is another way to convert in the sense represent the boolean expression to the SOP. So this is another way. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubts in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.